Today on Category 5 Technology TV, we're going to see what it takes to turn the $200 Pinebook Pro into a dual-screen Linux laptop. The Pinebook Pro is not a mainstream laptop for everyone, but for those of us who love to tinker, troubleshoot, and hack, it's an outstanding Linux laptop for just $200. For coders, web designers like me, hackers, and programmers, this thing has all the power and features that you need in a stunning magnesium alloy body. But one thing is true, we love working with multiple screens, so let's dive in to how we can create a dual screen setup with the Pinebook Pro. This feature is brought to you by Ameridroid.com. Grab your PINE64 gear and other maker tech at Ameridroid.com. Now, I can't promise that every Linux distro will respond the same as what you're about to see, or that every monitor will work. So a quick note to remind you that on my Pinebook Pro, I'm running a self-compiled version of Debian Linux. The steps to set that up are on a previous episode, so if you're having trouble getting this working with your stock distro, perhaps grab a micro SD card and follow the steps in that video so that your setup more closely resembles mine. Now, you can select a monitor that's right for you, but here's the criteria that I personally used when selecting a display. It has to support USB-C connectivity. Not HDMI to USB-C OTG, not HDMI micro, true USB-C. I want a clean one cable connection for the display, just a single USB-C cable from the Pinebook Pro to the monitor, and then the power cable for the Pinebook Pro itself. But I want to avoid having to add yet another power cable to power the external display. I wanted the physical size of the screen to closely match that of the Pinebook Pro's screen. It doesn't have to be exact, but eyeballing it, I want something close. Not only does that give me a comfortable viewing experience, but also lets me pack it all up neatly and transport the components together in one laptop bag. Besides, a larger screen would probably require separate power or draw way too much from the Pinebook Pro. I also wanted something that folded down flat, so no bulky monitor stands allowed. I wanted the screen resolution to match that of the Pinebook Pro, 1920 by 1080 pixels. Going higher than that could degrade performance or not work at all. And going lower would mean applications would be a different size from screen to screen. So matching both the resolution and the physical size of the screen means dragging windows from one monitor to the other just feels more seamless. Speaking of resolution, I don't want to have to mess around with odd aspect ratios. We know the Pinebook Pro handles 16:9 perfectly since that's the native aspect ratio of the built-in display, so I'll stick with the same aspect ratio to avoid having the display stretched or squished. And finally, I wanted to find a hugely economical screen. Since the Pinebook Pro itself is roughly $200, it wouldn't make much sense to add a $200 display. So I chose one that was half the price of the notebook itself, about $100. Since it's USB-C, I also love the fact that I could use it to connect to my phone to watch videos or to my Nintendo Switch to play video games. Let's get to it. When I first connected the USB-C monitor to the Pinebook Pro, it would power on, but then it would go to no signal or simply fall asleep. I checked the display settings and the OS wasn't even seeing the second monitor at all. So I jumped on the PINE64 community forum and I wanted to see if anyone else had the same problem. Sure enough, in June 2020, Dr. Yak pointed out that sometimes the Pinebook Pro only works in a single cable orientation, citing trouble negotiating which lanes are being used for USB 3 or DisplayPort. So Dr. Yak suggests trying to flip the USB connector the other way up. So let's give that a try right here live. I'm just going to disconnect the USB-C cable, turn it over, and then plug it in. Sure enough, my Pinebook Pro instantly detects the screen and extends my display. Absolutely no configuration was needed whatsoever. So there's probably a 50-50 chance that you're going to need to do the same, because apparently here in 2021, USB-C even holds true to the superposition feature. In a moment, I'm going to test the dual screen Pinebook Pro with a couple of apps that I frequently use. But first, there's one last thing that we need to look at, and that's why the Pinebook Pro suddenly powers itself off if I turn the brightness up on the external monitor. Give some thought to why this might be and join me after the break I'll show you how I fixed it.
Welcome back to Category 5 Technology TV. Challenging yourself is the only way to grow. Robbie understands this simple truth, and once in a while he sets out to learn by doing, inviting you to join him on this adventure. It's time for another Nerdgasm. Here's Robbie Ferguson.
With the additional power draw of a second screen, it's important to have the Pinebook Pro power supply connected. The battery won't handle the extra load of a second screen. Even plugged in, though, there's still a small problem. See, the Pinebook Pro power supply is only 3 amps. When plugged in, if I turn the brightness up too high on the monitor, this poor little power supply that's really meant to only power the Pinebook Pro won't be able to handle the additional load, and the Pinebook Pro will shut off. Once you know about this, it's not that big of a deal. It's pretty easy to figure out the brightness setting and which you can safely use before drawing too much amperage, but while it works to just keep the brightness down a little bit, that's just not good enough for us. So let's figure this out. As I mentioned, the Pinebook Pro has a DC 3-amp power supply, so we use that as our baseline. The monitor that I bought, it is using 8 watts, and we know it's 5 volts, so watts divided by volts, that's 1.6 amps. So all I need is 4.6 amps total to power everything nicely. So let's round up, and we'll go with a 5-amp power supply. Now keep in mind, if you plan to plug in other USB peripherals that draw power, such as an external hard drive, for example, you might want to opt for maybe 10 or even 15 amps, but that's overkill for this project. So I have a 5-volt, 5-amp power supply, and I've got a USB-A 2-barrel plug adapter that will actually fit the Pinebook Pro. It's 3.5 millimeters by internal diameter of 1.35 millimeters. If you don't have these components, they're easy to find, but obviously the two ends just don't match up. So we're gonna need an adapter of some sort. I could go buy one like this, but where's the fun in that? Of course, those ready-made things are much nicer looking, more professional than anything I can create, but that doesn't matter. I'd rather make something that I'm kind of proud of, and then I can do it a little bit cheaper and not have to wait for one to arrive in the mail. So I took some measurements and I designed and 3D printed a simple little adapter box. I soldered a barrel jack to a USB-A breakout, which now gives me a 5-volt, 5-amp USB-A power jack to power my Pinebook Pro. Hacky? Yes, but that's part of the fun. Maybe you'd rather PINE64 start selling a ready-made 5-amp power supply for the Pinebook Pro? Sound like a good idea? Comment below, and remember, TL is watching. With my 5-amp power supply, the Pinebook Pro runs great, and I can turn the brightness all the way up to 11. That said, if you want to stick with the 3-amp power supply, you'll do just fine. Just be careful you don't draw too much power, and save your work religiously. Now, performance is as good as should be expected with any multi-monitor setup. But this is powered by a Pinebook Pro. Think about that just for a moment. Now, I've got the GNU image manipulation program up here on the screen, and I'm just gonna drag my tools over here using the trackpad, and there we go. So now I've got my tools over here, I can be more productive. I've got my second screen over here where I can actually work on the image, and I can pull up whatever tools, paintbrushes, anything at all on the other screen. And it goes for programming as well. Now, as a programmer, I love to have like a test environment on one screen and my IDE on the other and be able to work that way. It just makes things much more productive. You no doubt have your own reasons for wanting a dual screen setup with your Pinebook Pro, and I'd love to know about it. So please comment below. And one thing is clear to me today, the Pinebook Pro is a fully capable Linux laptop. Adding a second screen is easy, and it works and looks great. Whatever you do, though, it's important to simply have fun. The Pinebook Pro is a platform that lets you mess around, do and undo, hack and rejig. It's entirely compatible with your ROCK Pro 64 SPC, and you'll look like an elite hacker when you take your shiny dual-screen Linux laptop out to play. Let me know how you make out. Hey, do you want all the embarrassing behind the scenes stuff? Become a part of our fleet, patreon.com/category5. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up and ding that bell if you want to see my bald head again. I'm Robbie for Category 5 Technology TV. Hey, thanks for watching. See ya.